Hello, everybody. Thanks for joining me for Soothing Sunday. I'm Dana Mentink, and it's fall, y'all. Or you're starting to feel it wherever you are. We're just starting to feel it here, and it's just exciting. Here in Northern California, we do get seasons and everything, you know. So I'm kind of feeling in the mood for Christmas. I just want to tell you a little bit about my book, Christmas Crime Cover-Up. So there's a couple things that I really love about this book. Number one is it takes place in Death Valley near Death Valley National Park. It's book five in a six-book series, and they all take place at the same location. Furnace Falls, my fictional town. Why Death Valley? Because Death Valley is one of the most interesting places I can ever even think of. And it's got salt flats and badlands and mountains and mines and ferociously hot weather in the summer and amazing flash floods and spring carpets of flowers. It's just an amazing place. And actually, it's been in the news lately because, believe it or not, there was a big earthquake in Mexico, and it actually triggered this sort of inland tidal wave. Is called a seiche, I think it is called, in a pool in this cave in the middle of Death Valley. Can you imagine that? A tidal wave in an underground pool called Devil's Hole in Death Valley because of an earthquake in Mexico. I mean, you can't make this stuff up. So this book, number two reason why I love it, is it reminds me of a visit that I made to Death Valley, and I saw these amazing donkeys, which I assumed at the time were just part of the desert landscape donkeys, but come to find out with a little more research that donkeys are a non-native species to the area. So enter Nora Duke. She is an estranged member of the Duke family, but her job is relocating wayward wild donkeys. And of course, you know, with all the drama in Death Valley and the topography and the danger and the wild donkey, you know something amazing is going to happen. So I thought I'd read to you a little bit from book five in the Desert Justice series, Christmas Crime Cover-Up. Are you ready? Here we go. Chapter one. Nora Duke gripped the binoculars as the winter drizzle beaded her baseball cap. Lying face down on a small perch of rock, she scoured the gritty path below them, pressed in by boulders on one side and plunging to the riverbank on the other. The December chill numbing her fingers was familiar, as if the desert climate patterns would be forever baked into her cells, no matter how far she ran from Furnace Falls in Death Valley. Creepy thought. She'd worn a dark hat, insulated jacket, and sturdy boots. Still, her hand stiffened with cold as the time ticked away, taking her patience with it. There was barely another hour before sunset to accomplish the mission. She held the binoculars tighter. "Come on, come on, where are you?" she whispered. An unexpected noise behind her made her flinch. The snap of a twig? Her friend Felicia returning from their truck? Probably just a creature prowling by the water. The Amargosa River bubbled its way to the surface in a few areas, like nearby Beatty and the Amargosa Canyon, where she now found herself, and where they'd expected to find their quarry. But the sneaky feral donkey had traversed an access road toward the nearby Sandy Ranch date farm. The wily critter had escaped. The earlier efforts of Big Valley Horse and Donkey Rescue, dispatched from Colorado, where she and Felicia worked. They were the cleanup hitters, so to speak, because the rest of the team was now back in Ouray attending the herd of 15 successfully captured donkeys. "The buck stops here," Nora muttered. "Gonna capture you for your own good, baby." The adorable non-native donkeys would quickly reproduce to the point of starvation if they weren't captured and rehomed. Made sense that the rogue female would head for the date farm. There was a small corral there where owner Zane Freeman kept a few horses. That meant a nice deep water trough, plenty of hay, and shelter from the rain. Donkeys were not fans of getting wet. Heedless of the drizzle, Felicia tiptoed next to her and sat down cross-legged on a rock. Nora heard the crinkling of a wrapper. "Can't you wait until we catch her?" Nora said. "She might hear you. Sound travels in the desert, you know." Felicia huffed out an unconcerned breath and spoke around a bite of candy. "I know. I grew up here too, remember? That donkey has her mind on other things besides my snack, and I haven't eaten since we left the diner this morning. Besides, who knows how long this could take? She wiggled a candy bar in front of the binocular lenses. Want one? It's nougat and nuts and loads of sugar and calories. Perfection. Nora smiled. Felicia's sweet tooth was legendary. No thanks. We're going to wrap this up quick. Seth will give us a location as soon as he gets his drone in the air. Felicia pulled the hood down low over her puff of rain-frizzled hair. Seth's a sweetheart. So nice of him to call us when he spotted the donkey in the first place. Handsome, too. His scar makes him look rugged, don't you think? Nora heard the calculation in the tone. Yes, Seth Castillo was handsome, and he'd come across as a good guy in their numerous phone calls and Zoom meetings, but Nora wasn't interested in anyone in this town. She could only hope Seth hadn't lived in the area long enough to know about her past. Her heart tripped, imagining what he might think of her. He's a stranger, she reminded herself. Odd, the way she felt as if she'd known him for much longer than the weeks they'd spent chatting via their computer. She realized her friend was waiting for an answer. Don't get your matchmaking gears in motion. I'm out of Furnace Falls the moment we capture this Jenny and the vet gives her the all clear. Nora paused. You too? She held her breath. Felicia sighed. I told Mom I'd stay for a few days after I help you capture the Jenny, maybe through Christmas. Things are better with her, and it'd be so amazing if we could finally put the past behind us, she said. We have some good memories from Furnace Falls, too, remember? It wasn't all a catastrophe. There are nice people here. One in particular for Felicia, namely her high school crush, Zane Freeman. Maybe Felicia would restart her life here without Nora. The thought formed like a hard lump in her throat. Felicia swallowed a bite of candy. When we talked on the phone last week, Zane said he was happy to hear from me. Couldn't wait to connect while I was in town chasing donkeys and visiting Mom. She paused. Those were his exact words. I can't wait. Her soft smile was almost lost in growing shadows from the towering pile of rock that sheltered them. Nora's phone buzzed. She shielded it with her hand and answered. This is like looking for a donkey in a haystack, Seth joked. Nora could not resist a chuckle. The guy was charming, she had to admit. As the co-owner of the Rocking Horse Ranch, he had the perfect setup to house the wayward donkey until it was cleared by a vet to travel to Colorado. An animal lover through and through, clearly. He'd bent over backwards to assist in the capture, too. If we had a haystack, she'd be chowing down there right now. I should have thought to bring one. You two need anything? I've got coffee in my Bronco. I brought extra cups, in case we were at this a while. He'd brought coffee for them? The gesture kindled a warm feeling that she immediately shook off. We're okay, she said, before Felicia could chime in. Can you see anything? Just getting the drone up. Give me a second. There was a scuffling noise. Flying drones is tricky and expensive if I'm the one at the controls. Crashed a few? How did you know? Wild guess. You said you're an Army veteran. I assume piloting wasn't your bag. Nope, combat medic. Felicia's eyes widened and she smiled slyly. Combat. She mouthed. Nora tried to ignore her as Seth continued. While I was learning how to fly drones, I hung one in a tree and spooked a horse with another. The guy who co-owns the ranch with me threatened to shoot down my drone if I continued practicing. She stifled a giggle. Alarming. No worries. I don't take defeat easily. Ah, here we go. Drone's up. Give me a minute to focus. Her attention was snagged by a sound behind them. What was that? She asked Felicia. I didn't hear anything, Felicia said about unwrapping the second candy bar. You two okay over there? Seth asked. Yes, Nora said, mildly annoyed. She didn't need coffee or coddling. I thought I heard... Never mind. What do you have on the donkey? Rain is affecting visibility, but... Oh, hey, looky-loo, he said. Seth was probably the only man she'd ever heard use that particular phrase. Somehow it suited him. Got a view of our missing burrow, he said. Sure enough, she's headed right for the corral at the date ranch. Perfect. I'll have Felicia call Zane and tell him we'll trap her there and load her into the trailer. Sounds like a plan. I've got a pen all ready for her at the rocking horse and Doc's on call to do the exam. Nora let out a puff of air. Their mission was almost accomplished. Good thing, too, since it was now officially dark, except for the glow of the crescent moon that occasionally appeared between the clouds. She shot a look at Felicia, who was silhouetted by silver light. She stood staring, not down towards the date farm, but away into the wild land behind them. Her hand was stopped halfway to her mouth, holding the partially eaten candy bar. What is it? Nora said. So weird, she said, still staring. I thought I saw a high buzzing sound carried over the rain. At first, Nora's brain could not identify it. Death Valley, immense and mostly wild, was a place insulated from the constant thrum of metropolitan noise. But this was a sound from her youth, before everything had gone terribly awry. It was an auditory snapshot of her and her brother side by side, tearing through the sand dunes on his all-terrain vehicle, 15 years old to her 5, hot wind blasting their faces. The memory was lost as her body reacted, reaching for Felicia the moment the oncoming headlights blazed up from the riverbank. And you know there's trouble ahead in Death Valley. So happy fall, y'all. I hope you enjoy the book, and thanks for spending a soothing Sunday with me, Dana Mentink.